against patriarchy, your struggles for true democratic equality, for an inclusive multi-ethnic society, and for an ecologically sustainable world. We pay tribute to all our sisters and brothers, Kurdish and international, who have laid down their lives for this revolution on the 25th of November, the International Day for the Elimination of Violence Against Women. We work every day to spread news of the revolution, to break through the deafening silence of our media. This is not an accident, my friends. It is a deliberate attempt to hush up news that will inspire us to pursue similar goals in our own countries when we discover that under the most difficult of circumstances, in the middle of a war zone, starting from scratch, in conservative societies, a dream of gender equality is being realized. The Rojava Revolution is the most promising political development of our lifetime. A gender revolution in northern Syria, the like of which is not happening anywhere else in the world. We must not allow it to become history. It is facing the greatest existential threat, even greater than the one it faced from ISIS. Turkey is an altogether more dangerous enemy, especially as it has air power. And now that the US has vacated that airspace, Turkey has used it to further its own vicious agenda. Although the men and women of this area won an amazing victory against the barbarians of ISIS, we are ashamed by the cavalier manner in which our UK government has abandoned the Kurds, has done nothing to bring Turkey into line, and continues to sell arms to Turkey. I hope everybody assembled here will at least make a commitment to boycott Turkey and to boycott holidays to Turkey and tourism, because it's the money from that that goes to fund the arms, that funds the oppression of the Kurds. In order to avoid genocide, the Kurds found themselves between a rock and a hard place, forced to ask Assad to fight back against Turkey, knowing that they would be outgunned by NATO's second biggest army. And we know what that means, being sandwiched between Assad and Erdogan. The Turkish invasion has been a gift to Assad. It has given him the opportunity to regain control over his entire territory. The flame of equality has been lit in Rojava. We must do everything in our capacity to ensure that it continues burning brightly. Here is a society embodying the ideas, dreams, and aspirations of progressive people all over. A society that could be a template not just for Syria, but for the whole world. The women of Rojava believe that the best way we can show solidarity with their struggles is to set up the same structures of democratic confederalism in the countries and campaigns in which we are active. We must set aside our differences and recognize that we are all on the same path to liberation, even when some of us take a detour. This is our revolution too. Xinjiang Azadi!
Xinjiang Azadi!
Xinjiang Azadi!